of the earliest jobs I got was to prepare working drawings for the County Hall, you know. So I did a series of drawings. One of them, I remember it clearly, was a section from the staircase from the ground floor way up as far as the 16th floor and the detail in the lifts. So that was my first introduction to the County Hall before the building was built at all. You know? It was very far ahead of its time because the County Architect, Pat MacSweeney, was a very visionary architect and there were no kind of high-rise buildings. The only one of any note, a modern building, was the Bus Aris in Dublin, which was built in the 60s. And that was a modern building. It was only 8 or 10 stories high and it was more modern than they had any such architectural buildings in London at that period, you know. So it was a brave move on his part to design this building, 16 stories high. It was the highest building in the country at that stage, you know.
The two statues outside the front of the County Hall were called Cha and Maya, but they actually shouldn't be called Cork names anyway because they're originally Dubliners. They were originally designed by an artist called Oisin Kelly, and they were to be set looking up at Liberty Hall in Dublin, but apparently the Irish Transport and General Workers Union at the time wouldn't get permission from Dublin Corporation to set them up on the footpath outside Liberty Hall. So I think they came down to Cork originally for an exhibition in Fitzgerald's Park, and eventually the Transport Union decided to, I think maybe initially loan them to Cork County Council, but I think they eventually presented them to Cork County Council so that they could be set up looking up at the County Hall instead of Liberty Hall.
Those were the days, my friend. We thought they'd never end. We'd sing and dance forever and a day. We'd live the life we choose. We'd fight and never.
Oh, it was an amazing day. I was at the opening. It was an amazing day. But prior to that, because I was working in the office of the County Architect, we came out to see the building as it developed. And one of the most amusing moments was when the building, before the lifts were put in the building, we came out and we went up to the top of the County Hall in a bucket. The County Architect Pat MacSweeney brought about 3 or 4 of us out, and we went into this bucket on the side of the County Hall, and we were pulled up by pulley right up to the top.
We were very isolated. Before that, if you were in the Race Department, you were in a certain community. If you were in Water Tech, you were in a different place. If you were in the Roads Department, you were down in Parliament Place. If you were in Housing and Sanitary South Cork, you were down in George's Quay. And if you were in the planning department, you were over in the North Mall. So they were all little republics. As it's transpired, that my wife, my present wife, my wife of many years, that she was working for the Southern Health Board right here in the County Hall. And I would have been one of many who would have made romantic acquaintances right through that interaction, like between the various services.
You met a lot of other people that you hadn't met before, working in other departments. As well as that, you had people coming in from outside, the general public, and people walking around. And some of the very good friends I made over the years, I made them in the canteen. And there were people who came in from outside who would be walking around.
You know, we had a social club going, great success. We used to have regular dinners and parties. We even hired the Delphinus. That was quite a big boat that used to come in to the quays. We hired that and had an outing down the harbour and invited people from other county councils to come with us.
When I started with the county council, a man who had been on my interview board, an engineer, and it had been about 5 or 6 weeks, I think, since the interview to the day I started, and I met him below in the canteen, and he bounded over to me and he said, "My good man, welcome to Cork County Council." And I thought that was wonderful, and I think it set the tone of Cork County Council for me, a place that was welcoming and friendly to work in, you know, a place that I was going to work in for almost 40 years later.
I started in the road payments section of the council, and I finished up in Housing and Sanitary Services, South Cork. All payments were made by paying order, by cheque, as we would call it. And even at that time, each cheque had to be signed. So that, if you were paying the, say, the road workers, where there might be 12, 13, 1400 people to be paid, you sign those cheques individually, and so that you had cramp in your hand by the time all the cheques were signed. I enjoyed my time working in County Hall. I enjoyed the comradey with other staff members, and I still have some great friends from the time I worked here.
And we had aimed all our lives to help the people and do the best we can for the county, and I think the County Council has achieved that, and hopefully they'll achieve it in the next 100 years' time, you know, and will be noted or remembered for an efficient service to the people of County Cork.